The next one is up. What's really nice in what I have here to show you is how that theme is so simple. How he developed that theme in many different ways to evoke different feelings throughout the entire movie. So first we have that montage scene here. So the music, of course, helps to connect the scene, helps to connect the montage, right? Also helps to reveal unspoken thoughts of the characters, feelings of the characters. You're going to see that. You see how you have just basically a loop of the main theme throughout the entire montage, but it's presented with different instruments. For example, here when they are like dreaming, we have that bell-like sound that always evokes dreamlike or even babies, kind of like a music box, right, for babies. And then later, the music slows down, right? And we have like less instruments, something really focused on that grief, right? Just one instrument, just piano. Really simple, soft, slow. I mean, even without any dialogue, the music helps to communicate and reveal unspoken thoughts. And later, in the movie, we can listen the same theme, but being played in a different way to evoke adventure, for example.
Russell, over here! Let's go!
You see how that is more adventurous? Not only the instruments change, but also it's kind of like fuller, it's kind of like faster. And the next scene is almost the end of the film. It is slower than the middle one I show you, right? It is fuller, but it's not sad, right? It's not like the same slow and sad we had in the first montage. The same music material, but in different ways to communicate different moods.